SpaceX has successfully ignited all six engines on its latest Starship prototype, taking a significant step towards ensuring that the upper stage will be ready for the rocket's first orbital launch attempt. Unfortunately, the same successful static fire of a Starship upper stage, potentially producing almost twice as much thrust as the booster of SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket, scattered superheated debris hundreds of meters away, igniting a major brush fire. It's not the first major fire caused by Starship activities in South Texas, and it likely won't be the last. Join us as we bring you, after successful Ship 24 static fire, what next Elon Musk and SpaceX plan for Ship 24 and Booster 7. Starship S-24 completed its first successful static fire on August 9, igniting two Raptor engines. Several unsuccessful attempts to test more engines followed throughout the rest of the month, and SpaceX ultimately decided to replace one of Starship S-24's three Raptor vacuum engines in early September before trying again. After workers installed the new engine and buttoned up Ship 24, the stars eventually aligned on September 8. Kicking off the test, SpaceX pumped several hundred tons of liquid oxygen and a much smaller quantity of liquid methane fuel into Ship 24 in about 90 minutes, producing a crisp layer of frost wherever the cryogenic liquids touched the skin of the rocket's uninsulated steel tanks. No frost formed on Starship's upper methane tank, implying that SpaceX only loaded methane fuel into internal header tanks meant to store propellant for landings. The hundreds of tons of liquid oxygen, then, were likely meant as ballast, reducing the maximum stress Starship could exert on the test stand, holding it to the ground. That potential stress is substantial. Outfitted with upgraded Raptor 2 engines, Starship S-24 could have produced up to 1380 tons of thrust when it ignited all six for the first time at 4:30 p.m. On top of smashing the record for most thrust produced during a Starbase rocket test, Ship 24's engines burned for almost 8 seconds, making it one of the longest static fires ever performed on a Starship test stand. Several brush fires were visible almost immediately after clouds of dust and steam cleared. More likely than not, the combination of the extreme force, heat, and burn duration likely obliterated the almost entirely unprotected concrete surface below Ship 24. Despite continuous evidence that all Starship static fire operations would be easier and safer with the systems, SpaceX still refuses to install serious water deluge or flame deflector systems at Starbase's test stands and launch pads. Instead, under its steel Starship test stands, SpaceX relies on a single middling deluge spray nozzle and high-temperature concrete, likely Martite, that probably wouldn't pass muster for a rocket 10 times less powerful than Starship. In multiple instances, Starships have shattered that feeble Martite layer, creating high-velocity ceramic shards that damage their undersides or Raptor engines, requiring repairs and creating risky situations. With essentially no attempt at all to tame the high-speed several thousand-degree Raptor exhaust, static fire tests at Starbase thus almost always start small grass fires and cause minor damage, but those fires rarely spread. Ship 24's first six-engine test was not so lucky, although the Starship made it through seemingly unscathed. Most likely, 8 long seconds of blast furnace conditions melted the top layer of surrounding concrete and shot a hailstorm of tiny superheated globules in almost every direction. Indeed, in almost every direction there was something readily able to burn, a fire started. In several locations to the south and west, brush caught fire and began to burn unusually aggressively, quickly growing into walls of flames that sped across the terrain. To the east, debris even made it into a SpaceX dumpster, the contents of which easily caught fire and burned for hours. In the days prior, the booster completed three back-to-back static fire tests, with 1, 2 and 3 of the 33 Raptor engines installed on the rocket. Both of which apparently gave SpaceX enough confidence to prepare for the next phase of testing. That relatively cautious progress only came after SpaceX attempted to test all 33 of the prototype's Raptors at once during its first engine test. In addition to readying Booster 7 for its next phase of static fire testing, teams of SpaceX workers took advantage of the unplanned lull in testing to modify the orbital launch mount. It's impossible to know what exactly was done without official confirmation, but it's likely that SpaceX was attempting to quickly fix the shortcoming that allowed the last month explosion to happen. Without a fix, it's unlikely that SpaceX would want to proceed with plans to ignite large numbers of Raptor engines simultaneously. A series of tests that must be completed before Starship can safely attempt its first orbital launch. It's unclear what exactly that fix entails, but it could involve a system to constantly flood the engine section with fire-stopping nitrogen gas, or potentially take the shape of a system of vents that will connect to every Raptor engine and remove methane gas before it can turn into flammable clouds. It's also possible that the return signifies that SpaceX is confident in its quick launch mount fix and ready to start large number of static fire testing on Super Heavy booster in coming time. As Booster 7 prepares for that next phase of testing, SpaceX appears to be modifying the suborbital launch mount and test stand Ship 24 is installed on, which could explain the lack of ship testing since August 11. If all goes to plan, Ship 24 and Booster 7 will eventually complete all the qualification testing SpaceX can throw at them and be ready to support Starship's first orbital launch attempt, sometime before the end of 2022. SpaceX's Federal Aviation Administration Programmatic Environmental Assessment, which fully greenlit the company's existing Starbase Texas facilities and launch plans earlier this year, only discusses fire PDF a handful of times, repairing and preventing future damage to wetlands. However, comes up dozens of times and is the subject of numerous conditions SpaceX must meet before the FAA will grant Starship an orbital launch license. Ultimately, given that the FAA approved that P in full awareness of a 2019 brush fire caused by Starhopper, an early Starship prototype that may have been as bad or worse than 2022, there's a chance that it will play a small role in the ongoing launch licensing process, but the odds of it being a showstopper are close to zero. Still, it would likely benefit SpaceX at least as much as the surrounding Boca Chica wilderness if it can implement changes that prevent major brush fires from becoming a regular, accidental occurrence. Despite that, Starship is SpaceX's next-generation deep space transportation system, which the company is developing to take people and payloads to the Moon, Mars and beyond. The vehicle is composed of two fully reusable elements, both of which are powered by Raptor engines. SpaceX is gearing up for the landmark Starship orbital flight, which will involve Ship 24 and a Super Heavy known as Booster 7. The company has been testing both vehicles at Starbase over the past month or so, performing static fires and other work. SpaceX founder and CEO Elon Musk has said, "Starship has the potential to unlock the heavens, making Mars colonization and other bold exploration feats economically feasible." He's not the only one to see promise in the giant vehicle. For example, NASA selected Starship as the first crewed lunar lander for its Artemis program of moon exploration. If all goes according to plan, a Starship will put NASA astronauts down near the lunar South Pole in 2025 or 2026. Thanks for watching this video and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.